Drewski's back!
With a beard.
Stills.
Have you not shaved it off yet?
No, never.
Why?
Because it annoys my wife.
So because you've got a beard and it annoys your wife, you keep it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, of course, you are a Space Wolf through and through. And this is probably going to be the last game on the channel with Space Wolves prior to their update.
Yes.
To Psychic Awakening.
Should hopefully be, what, next 6 weeks or something like that?
Well, Greater Good is due out any day. It's probably out by the time we edit this.
Yeah.
And release it.
Space Wolf sometime in March, I think they said originally.
Yeah, I think it was one Psychic Awakening boot per month. I'm excited for April though, for Engine War.
That looks really cool. I actually quite like how they've put the AdMech in with them, it makes sense.
I love the new AdMech models, yeah. They're so cool.
Chaos Demons as well?
Yes, and Chaos Knights and Imperial Knights. Yeah. So of course it'll be me versus Ian.
Yeah.
But today, you know, we've done things to death with like Khorne, and I've played Sean a lot with me Khorne, yeah. And me World Eaters, and I did Necrons with you before, and it was just like...
Yeah, we've done Necrons.
I don't... Blood Angels have just appeared last week with Rhea, and I use Blood Angels a lot, and it was like, right, what can I do that's something a little bit different? And I realised that I've never actually done anything Psychic Awakening related with Tyranids.
Yes.
So I'm running Tyranids today.
And they got some really cool stuff as well.
Yeah, but I still haven't run any of the custom High Fleets though, because I don't think any of them are really great.
There's a couple of good combos, depending on what models you've got.
Yeah.
But I think you have to build the combos around the units you have, if that makes sense. But there is some good stuff.
Absolutely. There's some good stratagems. The stratagems were quite good.
Yeah.
Especially the one to give the monster like a biomorph. It was a bit like a warlord trait, basically.
Yes.
You can give a monster or a unit those, which is very, very handy. I've definitely spent one command point on that. I may spend another one, potentially.
So you can get one instead of a warlord trait as well, can't you?
You can, but then you can spend the command point to get one as well. So I may use that on the unit of Hormigans.
Yeah, that could be interesting.
Yeah, to increase the Silent Talons rend by one,
yeah.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
I think that was one of them. I will double check when I go over the list, of course. But if you guys don't know, Drew is a Patreon, so thank you very much for your support. That gets people early access to battle reports. I try to do it. It's an almost weekly thing where I update everybody with what I've been working on and show off what models and what games and stuff I've been playing as well. You get a t-shirt in any colour that you want. Grant wants a pink one.
Fair play.
Whatever. But make sure you also check us out on Twitch, guys. We do hobby streams every Monday night. But without further ado, let's go and have a look through the armies.
It's quite big.
So here we go. I'm running High Fleet Gorgon today. Reroll ones in the combat phase.
Well, should be
I've never used this one before, so we'll see how it does. Unsurprisingly, Drew, I'm running a brigade.
Yes, that's good.
So, we've got the Hive Tyrant with wings. He's got adrenal glands. He's took the relic of the Imgal factor. And I spent the command point to take accelerated digestion as his adaptive physiology. For psychic powers, he's took the horror and psychic scream. And of course, he's got one set of monstrous silent talons and one set of devourers with brain leech worms. The next HQ we've got on the Warlord is the Neurothrop. He's took Synaptic Linchpin as his Warlord trait, and he's took Catalyst as his Psychic Power. We've got the Turvagon, who's got some monstrous Scythe Talons, not the Crushing Claws that you see. And she's took Onslaught as her Psychic Power. We've also got a Tune of Prime down the bottom here with a Death Spitter and Lash Whip and Bone Sword. For troops, we've got a unit of 30 Hormigans. Two units of 28 Turvagons.
Termagants. 28 Turvagons is a very different thing.
There is 13 with Devourers in each squad because I didn't have the points to make them 15 apiece. And then we've got 2x3 Ripper Swarms there as well. There's only... No, there's 6 there, that's right. And then the last troop choice is 5 Tyranid Warriors, 1 Venom Cannon, 4 Death Spitters, and the rest of them all have Rending Claws. For elites, we've got a unit of 3 Hive Guard, we've got a Lictor, and we've got a squad of Zonthropes. The Zonthropes have taken the horror as well. someone's supposed to have paroxysm. I can't remember who it was.
Is that your Turvigan? Is that Turvigan?
That's the Turvigan.
Yeah, has he got paroxysm?
No, that's Onslaught. I'll change that round in a few moments. But heavy support wise, we've got Carnifexes. We've got a unit of two normal Carnifex with dual monstrous scythe and talons and tusks.
Nice.
So it's an extra attack each. We've then got a Stone Crusher Carnifex with a flail and the claws. And we've got a Morlock because the new stratagem's quite nice.
Which one's that? Is it incoming 1 inch away or something?
Well, you still pop up up to an inch away.
Yeah.
And you do damage to everybody within range.
Yeah.
But it's +2 to your dice roll.
Yeah, that's good.
Which is very handy.
Yeah, it is.
Which means that you're doing your 3 mortal wounds on a 4.
Yeah.
So that is very, very tasty. And then the fast attack is 3x3 spore mines.
Cool.
Because why not?
Cheap.
Brewski!
Alright, so we've got a dual battalion and a vanguard. So 6 troops, you've got 2 squads of intercessors, one with normal bolt rifles and an Oxy grenade launcher, one with Storga bolt rifles, 2 5-man squads of blood cores, they're just bolt pistol chainsword, 2 5-man squads of grey hunters, bolt guns chainswords, 4 HQs for the 2 battalions, you've got a wolf lord with a jump pack, plasma pistol and power fist. A battle leader with a jump pack, plasma pistol, power fist. A rune priest with a jump pack. He's got the runic sword and a bolt pistol. And his 2 powers are Murderous Hurricane and Tempest Wrath. And we have a wolf priest, again with a power fist, jump pack, and his crozius and a bolt pistol. For the vanguard, we've got 6-man squad of aggressors, 10-man squad of wolfen, 4 Thunderham Storm Shield, 4 Claws, and 1 Axe, and then a Sergeant with Claws as well. And Murderfang over here with his Murder Claws. We've also got Lucas the Trickster, Ragnar Blackmane with his 2 little puppies, and a squad of Eliminators.
How much do you want Ragnar to get a new model?
I really do. I've already made my second Ragnar new model, because that's my own little conversion, and I've made a Primaris one as well.
Yeah.
But just I think, hopefully, well, the Primus one I've made for a diorama, so it'll be alright. But yeah, that's 2,000 points on the nose of Space Wolves.
Right, guys, welcome back to the channel after deployment, and welcome back to this ravaged planet by High Fleet Gorgon. And the Space Wolves have come to purge and take back the formidable fortress by Covid Models. It's a really nice piece of terrain.
It's an amazing piece of terrain.
I really enjoyed painting that out, and it's great to see it on the channel. So go and check them out, of course. The battle mat is provided, of course, by GameMat.eu, and the objective markers and the command point and turn counter is supplied by Terry from Demonscapes, who also sponsors the channel, so make sure you check them out. The mission today, Drew, is a chapter-approved 2019 one.
Yes.
With the Schemes of War rules, which I'm still getting used to. But the mission is covert.
Covert maneuvers?
Yep. And that means that whoever has the least victory points can hide
all of the cards.
All of their cards. Yeah. Which is very handy.
Yeah.
So, as it stands, Drew won the roll off and elected to be the attacker. I determined search and destroy, and I chose this side. Which means Drew will get to go first. Unless, of course, I seize the initiative.
Mm.
However, objectives, we've got 5, we've got 6, we've got 2.
3 under here.
That's 4.
That's 3.
3.
And that must be 1.
1. Cool. So, do I want to seize the initiative, though? That's the problem. You know what? I'm not going to.
Okay.
Let's see what would have happened. No, I wouldn't have anyway. However, Drew, I will spend 2 command points.
Prepared positions.
Yes,
definitely.
Just a quick note as well. You didn't mention your Warlord trait of relics,
yes.
Did you?
So the Warlord is the Wolf Lord with the plasma pistol and power fist. He has the Saga of the Wolfkin, which is a plus one attack, and if he kills five models, it becomes a bubble. I gave him a Relic of the Wolfenstorm, which again is a plus one attack bubble, any units within 3 inches. I also paid for one extra relic, which is on this guy, the battle leader, essentially a lieutenant, and that's the Armor of Russ for the 4-up invuln, and make something fight last in combat. Yeah.
Right, so cards for Drew. He's played Supremacy, Defend 3, and Hidden 1. So that is Defend 3. So yeah. He's probably going to get that. You know, me taking out 5 Intercessors at that range.
In cover as well.
Yeah, probably not going to happen. The Aggressors have advanced.
Only got a 2, unfortunately.
Yep. And the Sky Claws.
So yeah, Sky Claws have just jumped across here.
Yep.
And the Blood Claws and a couple of characters have just moved up behind them.
Yep.
And that's it. Everything else stood still. Intercessors, Grey Hunters, they all just stood still where they were.
Nice. Shooting phase? No, psychic phase.
Psychic phase. So I'm going to go for... You can do 2 powers.
Okay.
So the first one I'm going to go for is Murderous Hurricane.
Okay.
Which I'm going to... is a visible unit within 18. So the guys, the one with the black jump pack, so these guys are in range.
Yeah.
So I'll stick a Murderous Hurricane on these guys.
Uh-huh.
And that's 1 dice for everyone with the unit, and every 6 is a mortal wound.
Okay.
So I need a 5 for this to go off. It isn't. It does not go off. I'm not TP that.
Okay, fair enough.
And the last one will be Tempest Wrath, which is a visible unit within 24.
Uh-huh.
To make the -1 to hit.
Okay.
Which I will put on... The Turbigan's got some shooting, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's like 4 shots at strength 5.
I'm not letting me in 24.
Yeah, you can't see the Hive Guard, Drew.
No, you can't see the Hive Guard. What I'll do then is I'll actually just do a Cheeky Smite.
Okay.
And the closest one, which should be these
ones,
guys. So, on a 5. I'll re-roll that one. Cause okay. That is a 5.
I'll try and stop it. Stop. Yes. And that's it, shooting phase.
Yes.
So we've done most of the small arms fire. Drew has, of course, thinned out the termagants at this side. Thinned out the termagants at this side, and then he goes, right, 3 aggressors into the zone throps, 3 into the termagants. And he's doing the termagants first. That's the missiles. Come on, then.
Right, I'll roll them first, and then I'll do the bolters next. So 18 shots.
36 shots at them is basically going to kill us now, isn't it?
It should do. That's what I'm hoping for.
Whoa, not with that roll.
A lot of one, yeah, but there's still another 18 shots to go.
Yeah, but...
That's a lot of misses, though.
Yeah. I kind of wish I had taken Venom Throps now.
And then this will be freeze.
Yes.
Oh, dear. That's all right, actually.
I'll just roll these. So I've got a 5 up because of prepared positions. So... 4 die, yep. I'll take them 3. So that's 15 dead now in total. No, it's not. That's 15. So there's 13 left. And he's got another 18 shots.
So 6, 6, and 6, and 18. So same again.
Wow. Unfortunately, we are down to Devourers now, but at least I can get the 10 Flesh Borers back next turn.
A lot of misses again.
Yeah. 3's to wound.
Not too bad again, it's alright actually.
That's 6 again. 5's.
3 more?
Yep. We'll just take the 3 from this side. And then where was the other 3 shooting?
Zone throws.
Yep.
So 3d6.
What?
That's.
Wow.
Alright.
Can I have me dice back, please?
Nope. That's a 6. 6. And 6.
Good God.
So, 3. Strength, toughness 4 is on top, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so. 3's. That's a bit better.
For you, maybe. Not me.
Yeah, he threw it in one, though.
True.
And then these will be 4's.
That's all right.
Yeah, it's all right. Yeah, so that many 3-ups.
How is it that you get more wounds with that? Fine.
All of them.
And then the same again.
Same again. So 6, 3, six, and six.
I can't believe you just maxed out on shots. You know salamanders have to pay a stratagem for that.
Yeah. No, that is pretty ridiculous.
Yep. And then fours again. That's a decent-ish roll.
Yeah, that's not bad, actually.
Probably got. I reckon I failed three saves.
Nope.
One. Holy moly. I want them dice back.
Yeah, they've started off all right.
So, yeah, I'll take a wound on the guy that you can't see. That wasn't bad.
No, that was that was pretty
that
good.
That was pretty good.
The only thing I've got left to shoot is the Eliminators.
Yeah. Right, Eliminators.
Yeah. So these guys into the Neurothrope.
Yep.
So three shots with the heavy one. Oh, that's good. Is it worth a CP? No. Strength five, toughness four.
Yep.
So threes. No.
No. And I think all. That is shooting.
Yeah, I think that's all the shooting there.
Should I go and count up some dice? Because I've got a lot of Overwatch there.
Yes.
Right, so I've got 20 models, 13 of which have devourers. So that's a total of 49 shots in total. Now, because I've still got 20 models, I do get the reroll wound rolls, but the hit rolls is only in the shooting phase.
Yep.
And this is against your jump pack Skyclaws,
yes? Yes, they'll be charging.
So here's 25 dice to begin with, when I can actually pick them up. Not many.
That's four.
The strength four, though. So that would be two, and then I'll do the same again, minus one dice. Was that two wounds that I got before, by the
way? Two, yeah.
Three, four, five saves to make all
five together. Saves.
Yep, there you go.
So these will be no AP, isn't it?
No AP.
Oh, I'm covering the camera with my finger there.
Make them all.
Oh,
well, that was all pointless.
So then they'll go for a charge.
Yeah, what about your charge distance, though?
So the charge distance, let's get it up front.
Five.
Yeah, five. Ragnar gives them a reroll charges.
Oh.
So if the worst should happen.
Twice.
Twice, yeah.
Yeah, they're in. Right, so the Skyclaws are in, and Drew left a couple of small gaps for the captain and the battle leader to make it in. 51 attacks just from chainsaws from then 10 guys. And then the 11th guy.
He's got a power fist, so he'll...
Isn't he the battle leader, though? Or is it just
no, he's called a Wolfguard Sky Leader. So he's like a Wolfguard Leader, which you can attach to a squad.
Right.
So then that's the battle leader, which is a lieutenant. And that's the Wolf Lord, which is a captain.
So the sergeant and that...
Yes, you have a sergeant, wow. And then you have a Wolfguard guy as well.
Fair enough. So Drew's going to roll all this off camera because 51 is a lot and you're probably going to kill most of them termagants.
Yes.
So it only actually took the first 25 dice to kill that squad and Drew consolidated and just brought these in. But we did manage to kill one.
Yeah, you killed one with your six attacks or whatever you heard of.
Yeah, it's a shame that I'm not going to be able to shoot you because that squad alone probably could have took them out.
Mm.
Which is a shame, but never mind. So Drew scores supremacy because he controls three.
Yep, one, two, and three.
Yep.
And I'm halfway to doing defending objective three.
Yep, did you score your hidden one? Or
no, I haven't scored my hidden
are
one.
Are you keeping it?
I am keeping it.
Okay.
So I'll just get the D3 for supremacy.
Yep.
4-1.
Plus first strike makes 2 points.
Yeah.
Okay, so my cards have got Supremacy, Decapitate, and Secure Objective 6. So the Termagants are spawned an extra 10 with Flesh Borers, and they've retreated onto Objective 6.
Yeah, like girls.
Yes. Right, take it from you, because I've got troops.
Yeah, that's good.
The Stonecrusher's come this way. He's going to try and take out the Warlord, hopefully. The Turbogon has obviously moved up supporting these. Both Carnifexes have come this way. These guys on the outskirts, unfortunately, got a 1 inch for their run. And the Warriors have moved forward. So, into the psychic phase. The first thing I'm going to cast... the Zonthropes are going to cast the Horror on these.
Yep.
It does. I can reroll the one, though, because of the Neurothrope. So I'm going to try and get a higher one to try and stop you from stopping
I'm
it.
Not
going
to deny that anyway.
Oh, well, that's another one. Okay, so they're minus one to hit and minus one leadership.
Yep.
I'm then going to cast Catalyst onto the Stonecrusher from the Neurothrop. Get on a 7. That's the 5 of Feel No Pain.
I'll leave that.
Okay. The Neurothrop will then smite. I'll reroll the 1. I get a 10.
Denies.
24.
So the psychic hood, is it the...
It's if you're within 12, you get plus 1.
The psychic hood, yeah, so we'll not be that, but... Where's this guy?
Yeah, you're within 24.
So I'll try and deny that one.
Yep.
Just because he can deny.
Nope. So that's D3 mortal wounds. 3 on the Sky Claws.
Okay, so I will take... you, and you.
And then because I don't need Onslaught, the Tervagon will smite. She gets a 7.
And then I'll spend 1 CP.
Uh-huh.
Which means I can have a character deny like a psychic.
Okay.
So, you're looking for an 8? Nope.
Nope. So another D3 on the Sky Claws for 1. Oh, do I want to CP that? No, because I've got plenty of shooting to go into them, so... Right, shooting phase. Okay, so the shooting phase. We're going to go first with the Stinging Salvo into the Sky Claws. 4 shots. 1 hit. Strength 5. Fatal wound, of course. And then we've got the Death Spitter from the Prime, who is going into them as well. 3s. Wow.
Oh, dear.
My God. And then we've basically got Death Spitters and a Venom Cannon there. I think the Death Spitters will go into them. The Venom Cannons are probably going to go into them aggressors. Right, so hopefully some better luck with the Warriors. They're getting plus 1 to hit thanks to the Tyranid Prime. So 12 Death Spitter shots. Couple of misses. That's okay. That's
pretty good though.
Strength 5.
Toughness 4.
If I can pick my dice up. 3s. Oh, come on.
No, that's alright, that's alright.
7, minus 1.
Minus 1, so... How many psychics got there?
You got more than 4.
Yeah, no, but he's different, so I'd roll for him separate. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to roll 5 first, just for the 5 guys that don't have storm shields. So I failed 2. 2,
yep.
And then I'll throw the last 2. Failed...
2 more.
Another 2 more, so that's 4 die.
Nice, I'll take that. And the Venom Cannon into the aggressors. 2 shots. Both hit.
Nice.
Strength 8. 1 wound.
Minus.
I think it was
minus
1.
Minus 2, wasn't it?
Just roll, see if you fail, and we'll check.
I get a 5.
That's a pass. These two guys are going to shoot into these, so D3 shots each. So that's a total of 4. Needing 4s. That's 2. Strength 7's 3s. That's 2 at minus 3 for 1 damage apiece.
So these are 6 up saves. So, 2 wounds on one of the aggressors.
Yep.
That extra wound that they got is massive now, I think.
Oh.
I'll put it on this
ridiculous
guy. The guy at the back here.
Yep.
Where?
Drew put the wounds here. And when I measured up, if I charge here, he can't get 6 inches around. So, if I do more damage to them...
It's going to make it easy.
Murderfang can then heroically intervene. Yeah. And I was debating what to do with the Hive Guard. Well, now my option is clear. Get rid of them. 3 misses... 2s. That is 3 at minus 2. No cover save either, so you're on 5s.
5 ups. I made 1.
2 die. Oh no, sorry, it's D3 damage each.
Yeah, so roll the first one then. 1 dies.
I will CP that. There you go.
2 die. So I will leave you.
So that leaves me on 11 CP.
Anything else to shoot?
No. No. That, unfortunately, just leaves charges.
Yes.
So, it's pointless not declaring all 3 units over there.
No.
So, do you want to do it?
So, we have... He'll throw a crack grenade, because he doesn't have a pistol. He's obviously just got a bolt pistol. So, 1 bolt pistol on a 6, reroll on a 1.
Ruin,
it's going to be... Is it toughness 7 on a conflict?
7, yeah.
So, there. 5's wound, we're on, no, that's, well, 1, is he, if he's...
Yeah, he's within 6.
Yeah, so reroll that 1. Yeah, 1 wound with a bolt pistol.
Pass me save.
Okay, he'll throw a cracking head, the Wolfguard guy. Nope, reroll the 1. Nope. and then a plasma pistol, I'm not going to supercharge too much of Risk. Reroll the one. No, and another plasma pistol. Come here. No.
Oh, look, I'm in. He does stuff on the charge as well, but I'll work that out in a few moments.
Yep.
Because this can't affect his charging them.
Okay.
So they a lot of shots.
Yeah, well, they did move.
Drew, your frag storms. Four yeah. sixes, a five, and a three. You rolled.
Yeah.
In total, you got six wounds.
Yes. All saved.
All saved. Charge distance.
Seven?
I'll have to measure that.
Should get you in.
Yeah.
Can I just push him straight forward?
Yep. And then the other one's going to try and charge.
Yeah.
Yeah, he makes it with a nine. That's all me charges, so I've got living battering rams to do with all three of these guys, and then I'm probably going to go...
He has to fight last. Because of the relic.
Okay. I'll go with one of them too.
Yeah.
Right, so, on a 4+, your warlord will take a mortal wound. No. And then on 2 4+, these guys will. Two mortal wounds on them.
So that kills him?
Yep.
And that'll put one wound on him.
Yep.
Where's the two? There it is.
So interesting thing, I've got 4 attacks base, plus 1 because of 2 monstrous scythe and talons, plus 1 because of tusks.
Mm-hmm.
So that's... Yeah, it's fair. It's fair. So, here we go.
That's this guy, yeah?
Well,
it doesn't matter which one it is, I suppose. What is it?
Yeah, because if I go with him, you'll kill these and then he can't fight, so he'll have to go first.
Okay.
So, here we go then. 6 attacks, hitting on 4s, rerolling 1s because of monstrous scythe and talons.
Not bad.
3 hits. I'm strength 6, I'm wounding you on 3s, rerolling 1s because of me fleet.
Doesn't matter.
That's 3.
Minus 3?
Yep.
So, 6 ups. Nope, failed
3. 3 damage each.
So, the first one kills him.
Yep.
The next one kills him.
Yep.
And the next one will kill you.
Yeah! That's not bad.
No, it's good.
I like that. Because honestly, I was terrified. Because you're getting... Although you're at minus 1 to hit because of the horror, and you're at minus 1 because of Power Fist, you're still at plus 1 because wolves.
Mm.
So you were still hitting me on 4s.
Yeah.
Which was still scary.
Yeah.
So are you interrupting with those?
Well, he has to fight last because of my relic.
Yep, so there's no point in interrupting
so
over
there. So I'm going to interrupt with these.
Okay.
And try and kill that guy.
Yep.
Well, at least hurt him.
So you got 4 attacks each because of shot assault.
Yes. Well, one of them's a sergeant.
So 9 attacks total, hitting on 4s.
Oh, it's not great.
That's good. That's good. That minus 1 helped me for a couple.
Strength 8, so 3s.
Yeah.
Okay, 3 wounds.
Minus 3.
Minus 3.
Power 6 up. Yeah. I pass 1, so you can't kill me. So just 2d3 damage.
4.
Cool, I'll take that. I'll certainly take that. So I'll fight back with him now. Oh, I didn't do his tail attack.
Yeah, do that.
So the Thresher Scythe, each time model fights, it can make 1 with this weapon. Make d3 hit rolls for this attack instead of 1. This is in addition to the bearer's attack, so d3 attacks.
1.
So 1, which I hit, strength 4, which I fail to wound. So now he'll go with his 6 attacks because of, you know, lots of talons. 3 misses. 3's rerolling the 1s.
Nice.
3 at minus 3, 3 damage. Oh, sorry.
That's fine.
Yep,
yeah,
kills the aggressors. Gets me first strike. And I'm glad it was against them.
Yes. It's a lot of firepower.
It is. But now I'm going to hurt.
Yeah.
So who's going first?
I suppose it doesn't really matter. So I'll go with the warlord first.
Okay. Yeah, this is now a bad idea. I forgot about the Armor of Rust. I even asked him about the Armor of Rust.
Yeah, it's very good.
So, how many attacks?
So, I'm going to go with the Warlord first. So, he gets 4 base, plus 1 because of his Relic, plus 1 for his Warlord trait, and then plus 1 for Shot Assault, so 7.
Wow.
All on 2s because the Space Wolf, plus 1, negates the minus 1 for his Power Fist, and rerolling 1s because of himself.
And then wounding on threes.
Yeah, wounding on threes.
Rerolling ones.
The twos. That's six.
Not good.
Six at minus three.
I've instantly regretted this decision now. I pass one, so that's 5d3 damage. That's a lot.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Well, there's five there. There's four makes 9, 10, 11. I need to make four. I make one.
He can lash out though, I think, can't he?
Yep. And he doesn't.
Okay.
That's not good. That wasn't supposed to happen.
You killed the aggressors though, which is a big chunk of firepower. Well, and in combat, they're a big chunk of hitting as well.
Well, yeah, but...
yeah.
So, anyway, that'll be the end of my turn.
We'll be spending 2 CP to keep these guys around.
Okay.
Just because he's still actually a bit of a beat stick in combat with his power fist, and he's got a storm shield as well.
Yeah.
So it's worth the 2 CP, I think.
So I get supremacy for controlling 1, 2, 3 objective markers, and I also control objective 6 for D3 plus the 1. So I get 2 points plus 3 for first strike. Could have been better. Could have been better.
Score some cards as well. So I get me defend objective 3.
Yeah.
And this one was actually defend objective 1, which is that one.
Ah.
So I'll get 4 points.
That's bad.
Yeah, so that'll... What would you have? 4?
3.
3?
Yeah.
And then that'll put me on 6.
Wow. Turn 2, Drew has to show all of his cards. He's got Blood and Guts, the Stuff of Sagas, and Hunt with Cunning. What do you have to do for these two?
So the Stuff of Sagas is basically kill a vehicle or a monster. But if I do with a character, it takes the last wound, I get D3.
Yeah.
Hunt with Cunning is just basically kill something. And then if I do it with a unit that was set up on the battlefield this turn, mm-hmm. I get D3 as well.
So Murderfang's going to get at least all three of them.
Yeah, so if the Wolfen don't get in, then yep. Murderfang at least could get one for that if he kills Zircon effects. But if the Wolfen can get in and kill a unit, then they could get the D3 instead.
And he's the Wolfen going for the Hormigans.
Yeah.
These guys have all shuffled up along here, and then a couple of characters have left. Oh, I really wish I'd managed to take a couple more of those out.
I really wish he'd managed to take just one more of them out, because then I would have used the lone wolf strategy on him.
No.
And made him a character as well.
No.
That's what I was hoping for, take one of them out.
Right, so, psychic phase?
Psychic phase, yes. So.
Where is he? Is he?
That's the side of there.
All right, okay.
So, I'm going to start with... I'll start with the smite, which will be going into the rippers.
Yeah.
So, looking for a 5. Was off the name.
Try and stop it. I'll stop it.
And then I'm going to go for Murderous Hurricane, I think.
Okay.
Into these Termagants.
Okay.
So I need a 5 for that as well. I get a 5.
Okay. The Neurothrope will try and stop it. I can reroll the 1, but I'll stop it anyway. Right, that's it?
Yes.
So in the shooting phase, Drew managed to kill one of the Rippers with this squad from over here, and he did a single wound with a frag grenade. We lost a single hive guard from crack grenades over here, and all the bolt pistols from there killed a total of about 7.
Yeah, 7 termagants.
Yep.
So then this guy's going to put a storm bolter shot into the termagants.
Yep.
And he's got a heavy flamer, which we'll be putting into this Carnifex, the wounded one.
Okay.
He's got a blister skill 3, not 2, he's weapon skill 2, so it'll be 3s. And 3s. Nope, nothing from the storm bolt there. Heavy flamer, D6. 6.
Oh, no. Needing 5s to wound, though. Well, that's not good.
That's 4 wounds. That's pretty good.
I'm alive on 1 wound.
Okay. That's not bad. Okay. I need to have a little
You've thing. Still got lots of bolt fighters coming as well, haven't you?
Greyhunters, Autobolt Rifle Aggressors, Stalkerbolt Rifle Aggressors, and I've got this guy.
Yeah, and I just want to point out as well, I didn't use Single Mind Annihilation. I totally forgot about it.
Yeah.
Right, so first up is the Stalker Bolt Rifles are coming across to try and take out that Carnifex.
Yes. So 5 shots on 3s. 2. And it'll be 5s and 6s. No.
I'll take that.
Yeah, that's pretty good. The four Grey Hunters, the five Grey Hunters at the bottom through the windows are going to shoot the Termagants.
Yep.
Didn't move, so obviously Bolt of Discipline. Be 10 shots. On threes.
That's not bad.
And then threes again. That's not bad. Four.
Sixes. Three more die.
Okay. The Autobolt rifles.
Mm-hmm.
In range. 30 inches over that Tyranid Warrior.
You mean bolt rifles?
Yeah. They're 30 inches here.
Yeah, yeah, but auto bolt rifles
not
are different.
Not auto, sorry, standard bolt rifles. Yeah, so these five guys are going to rapid fire into the Tyranid Warriors.
Yeah.
So again, it'll be 10 shots. Threes. Oh, that's not good. And fours.
Yeah.
Yeah, one, a minus one.
Fail it. So there's a guy back there that is wounded, so now he's down to one wound.
So it's them.
I think that just leaves the Eliminator. Right, so the Eliminator can't see the Khan effect, so there's only one round that we can use.
Yes. It's not. I think mine are the wrong round. It says Executioner round, but it's the one that doesn't need line of sight. Plus two at the hit roll, so he hits on twos. Okay, hits. Strength five, so he needs fives and sixes. It does wound.
It's a five.
And it's minus one, yeah.
Four. Passed it.
There we go.
That's fine by me. That's an extra shot on Overwatch.
And I think that's all the shooting.
Tons of charges coming in. So the priest made the charge against the Rippers, and next up is the two Skyclaws against the Hive Guard. One hit. It wounds. It's minus two.
So I'll take it on the guy without the Storm Shield.
Yep.
So it's a five up. So he's dead.
Yeah.
Good.
I know why you've done this. Do you spend use the stratagem now?
At the end of any phase.
So the end of the charge phase.
I can do it at the end of the charge phase.
Oh, man.
And make him a character, and he gets two extra runes. And he doesn't get any extra attacks, but he gets two extra runes, and he gets the character rule.
Right.
So he can heroically intervene. He can't be targeted unless he's closest and things like that. So, yeah.
Charge distance,
so
then.
I'll do the charge for him first, obviously.
Yeah, nine, it's in with get that. Him down. Do you want to roll the battle leader and...
Battle leader, 10. And the Wolf Lord, 6. That should get them all three of them just down there.
Right, so down here, the Termagants managed to kill three Blood Claws.
Two.
Two,
Blood
sorry.
Claws, yeah.
And three of them made the charge in. Those three made a 12-inch charge. Ragnar made a 12. But Lucas is going to have to declare the Khan effects as well. So I do get Overwatch. D3 shots for one. And I don't hit.
So he needs an 8 to get into that Khan effects. Nope.
Fails it.
That's fine. Merafang.
Mm-hmm.
Is going to declare both Carnifexes.
Yep, 2d3. Just three shots. One hit. One wound at minus one.
So before,
minus three, sorry.
Six up, but six, that's fine. I'll roll just to see what it is.
Forward. Oh, look, he's in. Oh, no.
Obviously in the middle. The last thing, I'll go for the Chaplain into the Hormigans. They should need a 9, but he gets a reroll from the Wolfen.
Wolfen give him a reroll.
The Wolfen give out a buff of reroll charges.
Oh, Jesus.
So that's Ragnar gives out a buff of reroll charges, and so does the Wolfen.
Wow.
If he doesn't use the reroll charge buff, he gets plus one attack from the Wolfen.
Right.
But you can only use one of them, 9. So he gets in. So
do you have to declare before you do that as to which one, or do you just decide if you fail the charge?
If you fail the charge, you can reroll the charge.
Right.
So. And then the Wolfen will try into the Hormigans as well. So 9 with a reroll. It's a 12.
Wow!
That's a lot of good charge rolls.
But is that all your charges, though?
Yes, I think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, so Drew's going first with Murderfang.
Yes.
8 attacks.
Yes, 8 attacks. I'm a little bit scared about whiffing. So I'm going to put... I'm thinking 3 into the guy with only one wound, just in case he really whiffs, and then 5 into the other guy.
Okay.
I can still deal with him, because, I mean, the flat 3 damage, rerolling all wounds. So, and strength 14. So, I'm going to do that. I'm going to put 3 in the guy with 1 wound.
Yeah.
Just to try and really make sure he can't attack me, because obviously they don't degrade, do they, because they're less than 10 wounds. So, I'll do that first. Hitting on 2s. Okay.
2s re-rolling.
And then, yeah, so strength 7 times. Oh, no, strength 12, sorry, not 14.
Oh, so 3's re-rolling.
3's re-rolling.
Oh, that again would be nice. No, that's not nice.
But that was the whole whiffing thing I was scared of.
What's the minus?
So it is minus 3 and flat 3 damage.
Nope. Do I explode? Yes.
Okay.
That's going to hit everybody, though.
Yes. So should we sort that out?
Yep. So I'll, of course, fine. It'll hit him. It's just one.
One more wound.
Yeah. He'll take one.
So one on Murderfang. One of these guys will die.
Yep. One of my guys will die. And I think...
That should be it, shouldn't it?
No, I think Ragnar's within 6.
Oh, is it within 6?
I'm sure it's within 6. I'll double check. Oh, 2 seconds.
So 5 more. Into this guy. On 2s. 5 hits. It's good.
3's re-rolling.
3's re-rolling. It's another... That's not too bad. No, it's 5 wounds.
Yeah, this is going to kill
minus
us.
Minus 3.
Wow! Wow!
That's good. 6 damage.
That's very good. Holy moly. Right. I'm going to interrupt with these.
Yep.
And I have another stratagem to play as well, I think.
Okay.
So I've interrupted. I've used Feral Instincts to improve the rend of my Scything Talons by 1, which means that when Drew's not taking the Money Storm Shield, he's on a 5-up save.
Yep.
It's one CP. With the weight of attacks I've got, it's kind of worth it.
Yeah, definitely.
And I've used Caustic Blood because I'm going to lose models regardless.
Yes.
And it means that for every model I lose, I should do a mortal wound back on a roll of a 6+. So if you kill all 30, I should do 5 mortal wounds back to you.
Yes.
I am also very much aware that I can do implant attack if I don't kill one model, if I leave it on 1 wound.
Yes.
So I've got 48 attacks, and Drew is going to hold the camera for me because there's a lot of dice. So I'm hitting on 4s. I've got 48 because 24 can reach the Wolfen, 5 of them can reach the Chaplain guy, and 1 of them is too far up to fight. So this is just at the Wolfen. In fact, you know what? So that you don't do that dodgy thing, I'm actually going to put the other attacks into him first, because he can't fight us back. Because it'll make a difference, one, because if I kill them, you remove them and you fight immediately.
Yes.
So I'm going to put these into him first. Now, I am aware that there is a stratagem I can do to, I think it was reroll wound rolls of a 1.
Mm-hmm.
It's because I've got more than 20. That is my High Fleet adaption anyway, so it doesn't help me in this case, which is a shame. But there was no guarantee I was going to get 30 there. I need 5s to wound you though, because I'm only strength 3. So I get 1 on your Chaplain guy. And of course, it is minus 1 as well, Drew.
But he has a 4-up invuln, so 4-up either way. Oh, okay. 6.
Right, here we go. Oh, nearly there. Nearly.
You need bigger hands.
I've got giant hands.
Well, you still need bigger hands, apparently.
Right. 4s, rerolling 1s. Oh, my word, that's terrible.
There's still a lot of attacks, though.
Yeah, but that's not a good roll, Drew.
Well, it depends which side of the fight you're on, if it's a good roll.
It's a lot of rerolls, though. That's better. Right, so take all these 3s and 2s out. Actually, that's not bad.
Let's cut a couple more 3s. One more there. Yeah, that's pretty good.
5s. Oh God, there's still too many to hold. Rerolling 1s. Not many 1s.
There's quite a few 6s there, I can see.
It's a shame. Wow, there that's go. A good reroll. There you go. Actually, that's not too shabby. That's not bad.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
That's 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 16 saves.
Okay.
But you're going to have to do... This is going to take a while because it obviously depends where you take them, doesn't it?
Yes. Should we do this off camera and then come back with what happens?
No, let's...
So it's minus 1, yeah?
Minus 1, yeah.
So I'm going to start on the axe.
So no shield.
So 2 at a time, so it'll be 5 ups, yep. Minus 1. So fail two.
Feel no pain.
Two five ups. Okay, so he's got one wound.
Yep.
And then another one. That's a four.
Feel no pain.
Fine.
Wow.
Failed. Fine.
Wow.
Fine. No. Five up. No.
Okay. Right, so that kills him.
The axe is dead. He'll get the fight, but we'll do that after. Yep. I'll pull the axe out later. So on a storm shield now.
Yeah.
So three ups. Two ones. Five ups.
Why?
So one wound left on the storm shield. Three up. Fine. Three up. Fine. Three up. Fine.
Stop it.
Three up. Okay. Five up. Nope. So one storm shield's dead.
Yep.
And then I'll go another storm shield for another two. Failed one. But passes his feeling
pain. This is unbelievable.
Last two.
Wow.
Pass them both.
That is horrendous.
It is pretty horrendous.
Gonna fight back then?
So I'll do these two guys first because yep. They died. So storm shield gets three attacks plus one for shock assault.
Mm-hmm.
And these are on still threes because I get the plus one.
Yeah.
Rerolling ones and twos because of the chaplain. That one got knocked over. So that's yep. Four hits. And it's going to be twos to wound. Cause
twos strength, to kill.
Strength 10.
Four.
Four dead.
So I need to keep track of how many die as well.
Yeah. And then the axe gets three, but he gets another one because he charged.
Yeah.
And then another one for shock assault. These will be on twos. All hit.
Yeah.
And these are strength 8. So it's going to be twos again.
So that's so four, another four.
At minus three again.
Yeah. So that's eight dead.
Okay. So that's them two. That died fought.
Yeah. Interestingly enough, had I actually put one guy on one wound, I would have used that CP to do a mortal wound.
Yes.
But yeah. As it stands, I couldn't. But now you've got the rest of your charges to do.
Yes.
Rune Priest next.
So Rune Priest, he gets three attacks, base, plus one because he charged the shot assault. So these are weapon skill two. So fail two.
Okay.
They're only strength four, strength user.
So threes to wound.
Threes to wound. Nothing.
Wow. Okay. Your captain?
So
he's not a captain, he's a...
Wolf Lord.
Yeah.
So he gets his...
Four base? Four,
plus one for shock assault, plus one for his relic, plus one for his warlord trait.
Yep.
And these are all on twos with his power fist. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And strength eight.
So threes.
Threes, rerolling the ones. Nope. So that's five wounds at minus three.
So four, you're going to have to do these
one at a time,
yeah, because I've got three wounds.
So two wounds, so then next we'll kill one.
Yep.
Two wounds and kill one, so it's two dead.
So the hard guard are gone.
Yep.
Next.
I'm going to do the three blood claws.
Do you not want to do the five, because they'll probably chop through the whole squad? I can't interrupt or do anything else with them, so...
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
So how many attacks do blood claws get? One base. So
one base, plus the next one for the sergeant.
Yep.
Then I get five for the chainswords.
Yep.
And then I get five for their built-in berserk charge.
Yep.
And then I get five for shock assault.
Okay.
So these are on twos because of Space Wolves, reroll on ones because of Ragnar.
Yep.
Field two.
Strength four, so you're winning me on threes.
Threes, no rerolls because Lucas is out of the way.
Still probably enough for the squad,
pretty good.
Okay.
No, he's in a few sixes.
But still, how many does that kill? So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay.
There you go. Ragnar, you suck. You couldn't even kill a unit of Termagants.
Didn't have to.
Which then, I believe, brings you back to the Wolfen.
Yes, so that should just come back over here.
Right, so interestingly enough, they fight when they die. I roll a dice when I die. So I should have rolled the dice for Caustic Blood before Drew gets to attack with them. So I might kill another. I did one mortal wound.
Okay, so one of them's wounded.
Well, no, because you're going five up.
Ah, yes. No.
You cheesemonger.
Yeah, sorry.
But interestingly enough, right, if I had killed one, he'd get into fight.
He could have got the fight.
Yeah. And then killed more, and then I could have rolled two sixes and killed another one.
Basically, keep going until one of us is dead.
Yes. Yes. But now he's going to get the fight.
Yeah, I'm going to do the chaplain first.
Yeah.
Just because of the way you can pull away, maybe you could pull him out of combat if if the wolfman killed loads of guys.
Mm-hmm.
But you'll not be able to get the wolfman out of combat.
No.
So he gets...
Three, is it?
Three.
Plus one for shot assault.
So... He's got a power fist, but it's on twos because his plus one negates the minus one.
Do you know what? I can't wait till you have to do litany so you can't just give your wolf and rerolls.
Actually, that's the one thing that's going to make them slightly worse, maybe.
Yeah. All hits. Strength five, six strength, with the Crozius?
No, it's with power fist.
All right, okay.
So strength eight, so it's going to be twos.
Yeah.
Four dead.
Four dead, okay. Caustic blood.
So roll four sixes. Okay, so he takes two mortal wounds.
Yeah.
Because it'll be on the guy that attacked, wouldn't it?
I believe it is. The enemy unit that inflicted the final wound, yes.
So he takes two.
That's okay.
Yeah, that's good.
And how many did he kill? Four more.
Four.
So I might as well take them from there.
Yeah. And then I'll do the claws, because they should be enough. One, two, three, four, five guys with claws.
I'm just going to come back. So, unsurprisingly, Drew wipes the squad with the claws.
There's a lot of
Can you hold that?
A lot of possibly mortal wounds going to happen.
One, two, three.
Three mortal wounds?
Three, yeah. Which you can ignore on fives, because, you know, you're going to pass all three of these.
Pass two.
Oh, for God's sake! Really? Yeah.
So, I'll put a wound on a claw.
So, that didn't go according to plan. But you know what? I killed three wolfen, almost.
Two and a half.
Oh, wow, I expected more. Anyway, the Carnifex is going to swing back. Five attacks. Okay, I'll take three hits. I am strength six. Ah, crap. Okay, but I get to reroll the one because of my high fleet adaption. Three. Yes! Yes, Murder Fang's going down. Minus three.
So these are six ups.
No!
Make one.
Six damage. Six damage, bro. Still got me Thresher Scythe. D3. Three. Fours. Two hits. Strength four. One more wound at minus one for one damage if you fail it.
He's got two wounds left.
I know.
Failed.
He's got one wound left. Yeah. That would have been so good if I managed to kill him.
Turvigan?
Yeah. I don't even know what Turvigan actually does in combat. She's really bad, actually. She does have monstrous scything talons, though, not the crushing claws that you see. I've actually got three attacks, and I hit on fours.
Nice.
Okay. Better strength than you. That's two wounds. And monstrous seven talons are minus three.
It's going to be six up saves. Nope, two die.
It's d6 damage each.
Well, they've only got one wound each.
That's amazing. I didn't realise it was that.
And then you've got a couple of rippers over there. The wolfen, one can run if I roll a six.
Mm-hmm.
Nope. And the same with this guy, two guys die, their leadership seven. So again, one can run if I roll a six.
And the other squad, because I killed two on Overwatch.
Yep. No. I think that's it.
Oh.
And then I'll just do some 3-inch consolidates.
That's not the best. The Rippers didn't do anything, unsurprisingly.
Yeah.
Yeah, so my turn too. So Drew scores Blood and Guts for killing three units. He scores Stuff of Sagas for a character killing a monster. And he scores D3 for Hunt with Cunning because these killed the Hormigans. So that's 3D3 points.
Yeah.
Please roll three ones.
Two. Two. One. So five points.
That's okay.
I'll take that though.
Yeah. No, so, I've got to retaliate.
Yeah.
No.
That puts me on 11.
So I've still got decapitate and then two other objectives. I can't even remember what they are now. Okay, so end of the movement phase, the Morlock has popped up here. I will be spending the CP and Drew will find out why in a few moments. Not a lot. All the warriors have moved this way to shoot these. This guy has also dropped down here. So hopefully do some damage.
Your Reapers moved up on the objective.
Yep, the Lictor popped up over here.
And some Spore Mines.
And 3 units of Spore Mines dropped down over here. So, at the end of the movement phase, when this guy pops up, he does mortal wounds to everything within 2 inches. Unfortunately, I couldn't clip all 3 units. But I'm spending a CP from the Sight of Waiting Book to add 2 to my dice roll.
Nice.
So, on these guys first. So that'll be D3, but do I want to re-roll that?
Is it 1 CP that's right, Jim?
It is, yeah.
Okay, so you're down to 6.
Do I re-roll that? Go on then. There, 3.
Okay.
So I spent another CP. And then on the other squad, that's D3 as well. And 1. Not what I wanted. Not what I wanted. Never mind. Never mind. Straight into the psychic phase, however. This guy is going to cast Paroxysm on these. I think he gets it on a 6. It goes off, and then I'm going to smite to try and kill that chaplain. Oh.
Perils.
I'm going to have to re-roll that. There you go. So it's D3 mortal wounds, but I used another CP.
2,
which does kill him. But it puts me down to 4 CP, which is not great. It's not great. But it is what it is. So. I'm going to put Catalyst on the Tervagon.
Okay.
I get it?
Yep.
The Tervagon will smite. She gets it on an 8.
Because I've got my thing over there.
Yeah, he's within 24.
So I might as well try that.
Nope. So D3 mortal wounds. 2, which kills the squad, which is just what I wanted.
Okay.
Because now the zone throw-ups will smite. For D3 mortal wounds.
I can deny that with Ragnar.
Okay.
Which I will spend 1 CP.
Yep.
To deny with a character. Should do 8.
Yep. And then the neuro throw-up will smite. I fail because I need the 7.
Yep.
But I can reroll ones.
Reroll your ones, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So D3.
1.
Just 1. I kill 1 wolf. It's not great, but...
Yes, actually, I'll take a wolf, obviously.
It's not great, but it is what it is. So, we'll take it. Shooting phase. I'm going to use Pathogenic Slime, which is 2 CP.
Okay.
Leaves me with 2. On this guy, into these, which
plus
means...
Plus 1 damage or something?
Plus 1 damage, yes. That means I've got 12 shots with me Devourers, and they become 2 damage apiece.
That's very nice.
It is. It's very, very nice. 3 misses. It's strength 6, your toughness 4.
Toughness 4.
3s. There we go. So you're going to have to take it on your claw guy first.
So that is 7. So this will be minus. Any minus?
Nope.
So it's going to be the 4 up. Nope.
2 damage.
I'll leave that next. So he's dead.
Yep.
The next one will go on a storm shield.
Yep.
Fine. Fine.
Just stop it. Stop it.
Fine. No. 2 damage. So 1 storm shield dead.
Yeah.
And then the last one. Fine.
Okay, so which storm shield are you taking?
I will take this one.
Okay. And then I've got warriors to fire. Yeah. So I've got 12 shots with the death spitters. These hit on 3s. This is at the wolf, and unsurprisingly. Strength 5, so I'm wounding you on 3s.
Okay.
They are minus 1, though.
Minus 1. So I will... 1 damage?
1 damage, yes.
So first of all, I'll go on a claw, which will be 5 up save because of the minus 1.
Yep.
5 feeling a pain. No, so 1 wound on the claw.
Mm-hmm.
5 up, passed. No, 5 up feeling a pain. No, so the 1 claw's dead.
Yeah.
And then 1 left, which will go on a claw as well. No, feeling a pain. No. So 1 wound on a claw and 1 dead.
Yeah.
So I'll put you there, and you should be dead.
Okay. I've then, of course, got the Venom Cannon for 2 shots. 1 hit. That does wound.
Mm-hmm.
It's got good minus, so see if you roll a 6.
No.
No, and it's D3 damage. 1.
5 up. Yes.
Oh, why? Death Spitter from the Prime. All hit. 3s. 2. Minus 1.
So 5 up on the claw first. 2 is 2, yeah?
Yep.
5 up on the claw first. No. 5 feeling a pain. Nope, so the claw's dead. And then the last one I'll put on a storm shield. Fine.
Yeah. Mm, that's fair. So the Spine Maws did nothing to Ragnar, and the Spine Maws over there did nothing either. We're going to have the Spine Banks into him. 2 hits. Strength 5. That's 2 wounds at minus 1 on Ragnar.
Okay. So...
because if you take it on Ragnar, you have to keep allocating wounds to him until he's dead.
Yes, that's what I'm thinking. So, one, it'll just go on the dog. He's got 6 of save, so it'll just straight up kill the dog.
Yep.
And then the last one, I'll take on Ragnar, which will be 4 up either way.
Yep.
Nope, so 1 wound on Ragnar.
I'll take that. That's not too bad. That's not too bad. Okay. I believe it's the charge phase now. So, crap.
What?
Can't go with him first.
No.
And you've got the CP to interrupt.
Yep.
Damn.
Unless you don't charge, but...
I could not... But then the problem is, them. I'd rather you hit me back than charge and get an extra attack.
You got to make a 9, though.
I've got plus 1 because of adrenal glands.
You got to make an 8, yeah.
Let's see if he makes it. No.
Let's spend one of your last 2 for a 5 up.
Nah, it's not worth it. I really, really want to charge the Turbogon into him because I could take him out.
Oh, definitely could, yeah.
But at the same time, I would lose the Carnifex. By doing it this way, I actually do more damage to you potentially.
Yeah.
By killing Murderfang, so I'm not going to charge with anything else.
Okay.
So he'll go into Murderfang. I'll take that.
Definitely.
I don't like that. I do like that. Make a 6 up, please.
1 6 up.
No! Thresher's Scythe, 1 attack, and I miss.
You've got your Rippers over there, into the well, the priest guy.
Yeah. Actually, I was going to charge the Lictor as well, but... yeah, whatever. Fives. 2.
Okay, no AP, yeah?
No AP, no.
3 ups. Failed 1, so he takes a wound.
That sucks.
Yeah.
I've still got Decapitate, which is kill a character. And that's what I was going for.
I'll do the Wolf Priest. So he didn't get charged this turn, so it'll just be his base 3.
Yeah.
On 2s. And strength 4, so it'll be 3s.
Is it a power weapon?
Minus 3.
So 1 damage?
D3 damage.
D3, really. So you need a 2 to kill the base. Yeah.
2.
And then Murderfang?
Yeah. So he wasn't charged this turn.
So he's only got 5 attacks.
So he'll get...
because he had 5, plus yes. 2 for charging, yes. Didn't he?
Yeah, so 5 base. He gets plus 2 for charging, then plus 1 for Shatter Soul. So
and you don't get plus 1 to hit this time, remember?
No, so this is going to be on 3s.
Okay, that bad. Helps. That helps.
And then strength 12, so 3s rerolling. Right, make 2 6 ups. Well, you only need 1 6 up.
Oh, man, that's just totally changed the game for me now.
Yeah.
But I've got some good news.
Scored some cards?
Yeah, I scored 2d3. Behind enemy lines and Master of the War.
Nice. 6?
6?
That'll do.
But that!
Yeah, that's hard.
It's pointless getting rid of Decapitate because you've got so... Oh, no, I did kill a character.
Yeah, you did kill a character.
Oh, yeah. I get another one.
Nice. Well, that takes it up to 10 to you, 11 to me.
So quite. That's okay.
Yeah.
Turn 3, Drew's got secure 3, Kingslayer, and behind enemy lines. 3 is one of these two. Well, there's behind enemy lines, and probably Kingslayer. The Wolfen are also there as well. Such a shame I didn't kill Murderfang. Drew said, why didn't I put the Morlock up there? Well, the idea was the Morlock kill the Bloodclaws, and then I smited Ragnar off.
Yeah.
That was the idea.
Yeah. But Lucas has just strolled up, Ragnar's came across.
Yeah.
And obviously Murderfang's moved up.
It's really frustrating because, like, you haven't got that much, really.
No, not loads.
But I just...
I've got enough to still cause a bit of hurt.
Oh, yeah, definitely. But you've got characters.
Yes.
You've got 6 characters here.
Yes.
Right. Psychic Fears over there.
Yeah, so you might as well...
You might as well smite.
Yeah. Psychic Fears is before the moving phase, isn't it?
No.
Is it not? Oh. I never do one. So yeah, I might as well... I'll pop a smite.
I'll try and stop it with a Turbogon. I'll stop it?
Yeah, and fair then enough. I'll do Tempest Wrath because I can, which just would give the Rippers minus 1 to hit. or is it just an enemy within 24? It's a visible enemy, so it'll just be the Rippers minus 1 to hit on the Rippers. No, on the Lictor.
Okay.
Goes off.
Near a throw up.
Near 6, sorry. No, so it goes off. So minus 1 to hit on the Lictor.
Yep.
And that's it. That's Psychic Phase done.
Shooting Phase.
Yeah, there's not going to be a lot.
Grenades.
Yeah, that'll be basically it. He'll put his pistol into the Rippers. 3. No. Look this within. Well, he's got his plasma pistol. So you might as well put his plasma pistol into the Morlock.
Yep.
So you've got 2.
Overcharge.
No. Nope.
He's dead.
No.
Get him off the board.
No. And he can reroll ones. It's a 2.
Yeah.
He's strength 7, toughness 7.
Yeah.
So 4s.
Yeah.
On ones. No. Might as well stick a bolt pistol into the zone throw-ups.
A crack grenade.
He's more than 6 inches from them.
Oh, right.
That hits because he's
off
the board. No. Okay.
Murderfang?
Yeah.
Flame is within range.
Yes. So I'll do the Storm Boulder and the Heavy Flamers all in the zone ropes. So 3s, rerolling 1s because of Ragnar. No 1s. And 4s.
Yep.
2 wounds.
Fine. Right.
And D6 for the Flamer. 3 shots. And it'll be 3s to wound.
Yep.
2 wounds.
3s. Fine. Fine.
There's no shooting there.
Mm-hmm.
These Grey Hunters had to just move out to get range on the zone ropes. It's the only thing they can really shoot.
So
just put 5 shots in the zone ropes.
Yep. Well, you might as well put them with them as well because the minus doesn't affect them.
Yeah, there's... Yeah, but they could shoot that squad of...
Okay, it's up to you.
...things, and then they could shoot that one, they could shoot that one to try and get rid of your line breaker.
Okay.
So, no, I'll just do these ones first. So, 5... 4s.
2.
2.
Takes 1 wound.
Okay. I'm going to do 4 guys.
Yep.
Into this squad there.
Yep.
Didn't move, so it's going to be 8 shots. One of them can't see. That's 8. 3s. And they're toughness 2 or something, aren't they?
toughness 1.
So it's going to be 2s to wound.
Yeah.
6 wounds.
I'm dead.
So that kills those 3?
Yep.
These 3.
Yep.
I'll go into them 3.
Yep.
These 2 can't see. So 36 on a stalker.
Yep.
So them, so 2 will go into the zone ropes.
Yep.
And 3 into that squad of 3.
Yep.
So the 3 guys. That's 4 dice. Sorry, I'll roll that again. 1 hit.
Yep.
That won't be.
Oh! Wound.
And then 2 guys into the zone throws. 1 hit. That won't be a wound.
Nope.
And then there's these guys.
Yep.
who will go, because of rapid firing, I'll put three into this squad.
Yep, so six shots, yeah.
And then two into the zone drops.
Okay.
So six shots into the spore mines. Five hits. And then two to kill.
Mm-hmm.
Minus one. Three die.
Yep.
So that kills that squad.
Yep.
And then four shots from the two guys into the zone throws. Two hits and fours. One wound.
Fine.
Okay, so that just gets rid of them.
So that's the only squad that's left.
Yes.
And then you've got these three guys. Crack grenades?
Yeah, it's probably the best, most sensible thing. So
are they all going into the neurothrop though?
No, well, he'll be closer to the rippers.
Yes.
So what he'll do is he's going to actually throw a crack grenade into the warriors.
Okay.
This guy's closer to him, but yeah, he's but a character, isn't he?
Yeah, so they don't block for the
so
characters.
These two will throw crack grenades. In fact, well, yeah, these two will throw crack grenades into the neurothrop, and okay, that one will go into the Tyranid warriors.
Okay, so the one into the warriors.
So this is on a three, re-rolling ones.
Yep, three's to wound.
Three's to wound, rerolling ones. So one wound on the warriors.
Minus one. Fail it. I've got one wound. Okay. Kills us.
And then a three from this guy.
Yeah.
Into the nearest rope. Hits. And a three.
Yep.
Wounds.
Fine.
And then the character.
Two from there.
Two and three. Fine.
Fine.
Fine. Lucas. Did Lucas shoot with the plasma?
Yes, he did.
I think.
That's it. Oh, Eliminator.
What's he going to do? Oh.
So the Eliminator with the D3 shots managed to take out them last three spore mines. So charges, Drew.
Yeah, so I'm going to go with Ragnar first because he can fit through this gap.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to declare the Morlock because he's enough shooting, is he?
No.
And I'm going to declare the zone throws in the hope that I can actually get round to the zone throws,
mm-hmm,
but if I fail, then at least I'll get it in the Morlock.
Yep.
So I get a reroll with this. 5 inches, that won't get me round. No, so I'll reroll that, because even a two would get me into the Morlock. It is.
Eight.
Eight will get me there.
Yep.
So Ragnar will go first over there. Lucas will just declare the Morlock.
Mm-hmm.
Five. Just under 6 inches, that.
Yep.
So it'll push him straight in there. Murderfang, Morlock. Right. The captain is going to declare just the neurothrope.
Okay. Yeah.
So he'll go there.
Yeah.
This guy is going to declare the neurothrope and the zone throps.
Yeah.
Nine. So he's got a jump pack, so I can actually put him in there.
Yeah, as long as you're more than an inch away from the Morlock, which you are.
And then this guy again will declare the neurothrope and the zone throps. Eight. So he'll go there.
Mm-hmm.
Wolfen.
Yep.
Are going to declare do I do both or do I just do,
well, if you don't, I'm going to heroically intervene.
Yeah, that's a good point actually. So yeah, we'll declare both with the Wolfen.
Okay, so I'll overwatch with both. This is the death spitter from the prime as well as the three that are left. Yeah. That's okay.
It's not bad at all.
That's bad. That's one.
None of them are wounded. Is there any AP?
Minus one.
Minus one. So I'll put it on a shield. Saved.
And then the Venom Cannon. Two shots. One hit. Does wound. It's minus two or three.
Storm shield. Fine. Is that everything?
Yeah.
So they've got a reroll. Seven. That's enough.
Yeah, easy. Right, so Drew's going first with Murderfan because he thinks that even though the Morlock is terrible, one wound's not bad to get through.
Yes.
Right, so eight attacks.
Eight attacks because he charged.
Hitting on twos.
On twos.
Rerolling ones because of Ragnar. Nice. Strength.
Strength 12.
So threes. Wait there, the Morlock might be toughness 6. Because I don't think. Yeah, he is. He's toughness 6.
So it's twos then.
Yep.
Rerolling ones. Because okay. He rerolls everything because of his claws. It's 3 ones.
Ugh.
But no, that's that many.
-3?
8 wounds at -3.
Oh, look, I'm dead.
Well, you still have a couple of them, though. But yeah, he did.
Unsurprisingly, I heroically intervened with the Turbogon. But I'm going to spend 2 CP and interrupt. I know it's like a lot of CP, but I need to try and kill the Wolfen. You know, with 3 attacks each from the Warriors, I'm hitting on 2s. I think they were only strength 4, though. That's the only issue with the Warriors. Yeah, strength 4, but we might get it. This is my last 2 CP, of course. I'm hitting on 2s because of the prime. I've got rending claws as well, so this makes a difference if I roll 6s. But I'm rerolling 1s to wound because of my high fleet trait.
3 6s.
Okay, so you've got 2 storm shields anyway. But you know what? Go with the storm shield. Well, take the no rend ones first.
Okay. So they're just flat.
Yeah.
So I'll do it on 1 damage.
1 damage.
So I can just do one, 2 at a time on a claw. So he takes both.
Yep. Feel no pain.
He's got 1 wound left.
Yeah, and then the next one is at -3.
So this will go straight to the feel no pain.
Yep. Kills him. And then 2 down. 3 ups. Well, unless you want to take them on another claw.
No, I'll take. So he'll be dead.
Yeah.
And then I'll take these on a storm shield. I'll do them 2 because they're only 1 damage.
Yeah, yeah.
Love yeah, it.
Fine. So then you immediately get the fight back.
My dead guy, so he gets 3 attacks base, +1 for 2 claws, +1 for shock assault.
Yeah.
On 2s because he charged. 2 ones though. And the strength 6.
So 3s.
3s rerolling because of claws. Doesn't matter. 3 wounds, -2.
Only -2?
On the claws it is, yeah.
That is 1 pass save. What's the damage?
Just 1 damage each.
Oh! You don't even kill someone?
The claws are good for, like,
horde clearance.
Horde stuff, yeah.
Yeah. Actually, you know what? That's almost worth that 2 CP to take a Wolfen out.
Hmm?
Yeah, you're going to hurt us when you come back with your hammers and stuff, but yeah, that's not bad. Anyway, rest of your combat.
Right.
Who's next? Wolflord Battle Leader?
Yeah, we'll do that one into the
So he's got 4 base, Shock Assault 5, Wolfstone 6, Saga of the Wolf 7.
Yeah.
See, I'm learning Space Wolves.
Yeah. So 2s, rerolling 1s. Doesn't matter.
2s.
2s.
Rerolling 1s.
Doesn't matter. 3 ups.
2 go through.
4 damage.
I'm on 1 wound.
Okay. So I'm going to go with Ragnar next. Because what happens to the Zoanthropes could decide what I do with these two characters.
Yeah.
So Ragnar gets 5 base +1 for shot assault.
Yeah.
2, 3, 1, 1s. All hit.
Yeah.
Strength 5.
So 3s.
3s. And is he within 6?
Yeah, he's within
1,
6.
1, 1 to reroll. So 6 wounds, minus what? Doesn't matter. -4.
So I'm guessing he's going into the Neurothrope then.
This guy is going to go into the Neurothrope.
Mm-hmm.
So he gets 2 normal, shock assault. He's within, do that one for the +1 for the relic. And he gets Berserk Charge because he gets Blood Claw.
Yeah.
So this is
you didn't use the Wolfen Stratagem and give him 2 extra attacks.
It gives him 2 extra wounds.
Oh, right.
It makes him a character.
Right, right, right.
And he can reroll all hits on all wounds for the rest of the game.
Right.
But you don't get extra attacks.
Okay.
But still a good amount of attacks.
Yeah.
All hits. And then it's going to be 2s.
2s, rerolling.
Rerolling 1s.
Yeah, 2 go through, kills us.
Right.
Regardless of what the damage is.
So that frees up this guy.
Yep.
To attack the Turbogon.
Yep.
So he has.
He didn't declare the charge against the Turvigan.
Did I charge them both? No. Oh, no, you know what I mean. Yeah, you're right,
So he'll do the zone drops. Yeah.
So he gets three, shock assault, and then the stone off the other guy, the relic. Reroll those ones. All hit.
Yep.
And it's going to be twos again. Reroll ones. All wound.
One. D3 damage.
Two damage.
Kills him.
Okay.
And then you're wolfing.
Wolfing, yeah.
So you've got one claw and two hammers.
Yes.
Two hammers can hit the prime.
Yes. So...
But with the amount of attacks they've got...
One could kill the
prime. One could kill him, yeah.
So what I'm going to do is... I'm going to put one at the prime.
Yeah.
And I'm going to put this claw and this hammer into the warriors.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do... Three attacks with the first hammer into the prime.
Yeah.
Plus one for his shock assault.
Mm-hmm.
And this is on threes.
Yeah.
Four hits.
Yeah.
And this is strength 10 because they're strength 5 base.
I am toughness 5, but so still twos.
Twos. Four wounds, minus 3.
I need three sixes. Nope. He's dead.
And then I'll do the other four hammer attacks into the warriors.
Yeah.
That one misses. And these are strength, but there's twos anyway, isn't it?
Yeah.
Three more, minus 3. Three damage each.
He's one on one wound.
And that's the claws. One, two, three base for sergeant, four. Yeah, that.
Two hits?
No, two hits because you charged.
Yeah.
Two ones missed though. Rerolling that one. The three will wound because it's strength 6.
Yeah.
That one. Yeah, so three wounds and minus 2.
Sixes. Nope.
Three damage.
Kills him. And then him over there against the...
Oh, of course, yeah.
Against the... What do you call it?
I can see the tip of his sword sticking up there. So, three.
Okay.
And...
Threes.
Yeah. Two.
Was
minus
it...
Minus three.
Oh, no, save. 2d3 damage.
2d3, yeah.
Kills us.
Yeah, three damage.
Yeah. So then I will go with Turvigon. One hit. This is at the...
Yep.
It does wound, and it's minus good. He doesn't have an invuln, though, does he?
He does, because the relic gives him
a 4. Oh, it's the lieutenant, isn't it?
Yeah, so he gets the 4 up invuln with the relic. That's why it's good, because you get two things from it. But he fails.
D6 damage.
Oh, do I want to CP that, though? Sorry.
Oh. Well, I'm going to have to re-roll, even though it's a 6.
Yeah, I will.
Yeah.
So it'd be stupid not to CP that. No, it doesn't matter.
Five. Kills him. Hey, that was alright. And then I've got the Zonthrobes that are going to tickle the other guy back. I don't even know what Zonthrobes do in combat. I've never, ever had Zonthrobes in combat.
They don't do a lot.
One attack each, hitting on fours at strength 4. Nope, nothing. And that's it.
So
what do you score, Drew?
Well, I'm just looking to see if I've got a thing that you make.
What, to fight again?
Yeah.
I'm hoping you don't. I'm guessing you probably do.
Yeah.
So Drew is spending 2 CP for owning Death Does Duty End, which was for this guy to fight.
So you'll get his 3, and then because he charged that turn, and then so it's 5.
Yeah.
So again, it's going to be on 2s, 3, 1, 1s. And it's strength 8, toughness 8.
Yep. 4s, 3, 1, 1s. What? Two?
Two.
Minus three. So six up. Nope. 2d3 damage. Three. Do you want 3 CP from Ragnar to fight again?
Yeah, because you've not got that much left that you can actually do.
Well, it doesn't have to be Ragnar. It could be him.
Yeah, Ragnar gets...
Oh, he's got more... Ragnar's got more attacks, hasn't he?
He's got the flat 2 damage on his...
Yeah.
So...
Are you going to do it?
Yeah, I'm going to
do it. Yes!
So that's all the CP gone from the game.
Yeah.
So, shot myself. You would just... You have to pardon.
Yeah, 2s re-roll it. Oh, a couple more ones would be really nice.
That's okay.
Strand 6 though. 3. So 3's rerolling 1s.
No, there's no reroll 1s now because the lieutenant's dead.
Ah, right.
So it's 3.
Yeah.
Minus 4, but doesn't matter.
So, but it's flat 2 damage. So if I fail 2, nope. Nah. Oh well.
So,
points. So you get Slayer the Warlord.
Yes, you get 1 for that. I've got King Slayer for D3.
Yep.
1.
Mm-hmm.
I've got Secure Objective 3.
Yep.
It's one of these two. And I've got Behind Enemy Lines.
For D3 victory points.
Yeah, so another D3. 2. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5 for Slayer the Warlord.
Yep.
So that'll take me up to...
To my 10. I need a good hand here. So I've placed me 3 cards. I'm not going to show use or Drew. I've done my movement. He's moved up. They've retreated and moved up. Lictor's moved up there. And you know what? They're going to move around to here. Just because then I can shoot characters if I want, because characters don't block characters.
No, yeah.
So, psychic phase. These guys will smite. Yep, that's a 10.
He's dead.
Yeah.
Only got one wound anyway, so the D3 doesn't matter.
Do you want to see if he blows up?
Oh, yeah.
Hey, I'll take the mortal wound, right? If it means I'm hurting Lucas any day of the week.
I think it's just D3 within 3 inches, maybe.
I hope it's within 6. If it's within 6, you're in trouble, mate.
Each unit within 3 inches gets D3 mortal wounds.
Oh, how many? D3?
D3.
Oh, that's okay then. So D3 on my zone throw-ups?
2.
Okay. And...
Lucas?
No, I want to roll this. Oh, for God's sake. I should have let you roll it.
Yeah, you should have.
So next up, he's going to cast Psychic Scream. That goes off. That's D3 mortal wounds on Ragnar for 3.
Nice.
And then he'll smite. I get it. On a 9, kills him.
Yeah.
Then he'll smite. That goes off. For 2, leaves Lucas on 1 wound. Lieutenant. I'm going to go for the captain with the spine banks. 2 hits, 3s, nothing. And then the spine fists from the rippers into him. One wound.
Yep, take it.
Cool. Next up, we're going to have the Hive Tyrant shoot into him.
Cool.
Come on.
What's the AP?
None.
So he's going to get a 2-up save?
Yes. It's a shame. Okay.
Does he not have like flesh hooks or something?
He does, but I've got no idea what to do, so let's have a look. Right, charge phase. Turvagon will go to Lucas. I don't know, actually. Rippers will go to Lucas.
Okay, so I'll do a frag grenade.
Yep.
One shot. No.
7 should get them in. So the Rippers made that. The Turvagon failed against them. I rolled a 3. Hive Tyrant is going to declare against him. 8? Okay. Comes in 9 because adrenal glands.
Yeah, I think that should get you in.
Yep. You've got no... Has he got the fight last thing?
No, that guy's dead.
All right, okay then. Yes, the Lictor's going to charge. You get Overwatch.
I keep forgetting about back here.
I'll make it on a 6.
You will get Overwatch, but it must be a crack grenade. No.
Right, well, the Lictor is going to fight first. Unfortunately, I'm at minus one to hit. So I'm only hitting you on threes.
He's going to heroic intervene.
Yeah.
Is it 6 inches?
Yeah, because silly, stupid Space Wolf ruling. I'm going to go with the Rending Claws with the Lictor. So I get 5 attacks, but I'm hitting on threes with the minus one that you cast on us. Yeah. One miss. I'm strength 6, I'm winning on threes. I reroll ones because of High Fleet Gorgon. That's 3. No AP. Sorry. I should have gone with the Grasping Talon. Yeah, we'll go with the Grasping Talon. So it's minus 1, 2 damage.
Okay, so 4 ups. Roll field 2.
4 damage. Yep.
I'll pick him up in a minute because I can't reach him.
Yep.
Okay, next.
I'll go with the Rippers next. See if I can kill Lucas. This is going to be hard now, actually.
Lucas is minus 1 to hit in the 5 phase.
Oh, great. I'll get 1 hit. I wound you, though.
Okay. No AP?
No.
Saved it.
There's me Ripper's gone, then. And then I've got the Hive Tyrant last.
Into the Wolf God Sky Leader.
Yep. So I've got 4 attacks because I've got Monstrous Seven Talons, I can reroll hit rolls of a 1. So 4 attacks at strength 6, and I'll be rerolling wound rolls of a 1. All hit.
Nice.
Threes. Reroll them. Unfortunately, sixes don't do anything special, but they are minus 3 for 3 damage each.
He's got a Storm Shield. He's fine.
And for the sake of it, my tail misses.
Is that all your attacks?
That's all my attacks.
I'll do the Rune Priest. He was charged, he'll get the Shot Assault.
The Rune Priest?
Oh, he's dead, man, isn't he? Sorry, I do, Lucas, sorry. So he gets 4 Shot Assault. 2s. That's a miss. And these, they're only Toughness 2, aren't they?
Or toughness 3.
Toughness 3?
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be 3s. Reroll okay. Everything because it's a glot.
What's the minus?
It is minus 2, I believe.
Right, well, that's 3 wounds, so that kills 1 base.
I think the 2 damage each, so
oh.
I'll double check.
If it's 2 damage, it'll leave us on 1 wound on the next base.
Yeah, minus 2 do damage.
Okay. And then you've got both guys against him.
So I'll do here the one that was charged first.
Well, you might as well do the heroically intervene one. Forgot the Imgal factor right there. So that's plus 1 strength, so it wouldn't have made any difference.
So he gets 1, 2, Shock Assault, Berserk Charge, and the Relic. This is the Sky Leader guy, the one that was charged. 3s, because he was charged. 3 rolling 1s. I'll do.
Toughness 7.
Eight, so it's going to be 3s.
Yep.
No rerolls, though. 3 wounds minus 3.
1 goes through.
D3 damage. 3 damage.
Yep.
And then the Wolf Lord himself, 4. He made a heroic mention, so he still gets Shot of Souls. He gets his Relic, and then he gets his War Trace. 2s, 3 1 1s. All hit.
Yep.
And 3s.
4.
4.
1 goes through. 2 go through, sorry.
4 4 damage.
Yep, leaves him on 5 remaining. Can't find the 5. But yeah. Right, that's the end of the turn. Right, so I score Assassinate for D3.
Nice.
I score Dominate because I got at least 3 psychic powers off.
Cool.
So D3 plus 1. 2 points. I'll keep that last card as well.
So that takes you to 12. 16.
Yeah, I don't think this is going to work very well now. Right, so it's a very quick turn here for Drew. The cards that he's drawn are Counterattack, Witch Hunter, and Unleash the Wolves. So make 2 charges.
Mm-hmm.
Which one's Unleash the Wolves?
That's make 2 charges.
All right.
And then Witch Hunt, obviously, Killer Psyker. Counterattacks, Mate of Horror, you mentioned. Can't really do that this turn, but I had nothing else better to do.
No, so all the Bolt of Fire's gone in. Some of the Zonthropes have lost damage. The High Tyrant lost a wound to the Plasma Pistol. But this guy's going to put his D3 shots into the one wound Zonthrop.
Two shots.
Yep.
The D3 shots one, is that the one where you get... No, it's nothing different.
So it's two hits. Yep.
And the strength five, so it's going to be threes.
One wound.
Fine.
So they've already shot as well. Shot.
So this, the 10 shots from this will all go into the zone throw. Just try and secure that psychic.
So, I reckon you'll get four wounds.
So threes. Fours. Four wounds.
Called it. Dead.
Want a stick?
Yeah, yeah, there we go. So that's Killer Psyker. Oh, that's the old metal one as well.
Right. And I think
Lucas has got a pistol.
Yes, he has. Plasma pistol. On a two. Hits. And that'll be two shooting.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Kills that base.
And the Wolfen are probably going to charge the Tervagon.
Yes. So, charges. It'll be Wolfen into the Tervagon.
One wound minus one.
So it'll go on the claw.
Yeah. It's only one damage. It's one damage.
I'll put it on a shield then. Fine. So they get a reroll.
They're making seven, them with a seven anyway.
Just push it straight ahead. And then this is the key one. So I need an eight.
Yep. Nine. Boom. That's his nine.
So that gets me to me two charges.
Yeah.
Just go that way.
So, do you want,
there's no interrupting.
So I can't interrupt. The weight of dice alone from these will kill them.
With Lucas as well.
Yeah. There's no point in your rolling there.
They would have piled in, so they'll just be there.
So, the Wolfen?
The Wolfen, I will do next, yeah.
So, you might as well go for the two hammers.
Yes. So, one, two, three, one, two, three, and shock assault and shock assault. On threes. Three ones there. And
threes.
Strength tens, so yeah, threes. Oh, that's not good.
One. Are you within range to re-roll that one?
There's no lieutenant.
Oh, right, okay.
Lucas is only does that for blood claws.
Right, okay. Feel me save. Three damage, range. That's six damage taken. Leaves me on eight wounds remaining. That's okay.
Yeah.
And then you get first swing at the High Tyrant.
So obviously go with my Warlord because he gets more attacks.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll get his four base,
yep,
plus the one for his relic, plus the one for his water trait, but he won't get shot assault, obviously.
And you won't get plus one to hit either.
No. So these will be on two, threes, yep, for minus one. Rerolling that one. That's not too bad, though.
Nope.
Strength base.
Threes.
Threes. Four.
Four plus. One.
D3. One damage.
Unsurprisingly, I'm going to go back next with me Hive Tyrant.
Yep.
But I don't have very many attacks now.
Yes.
I think he only has three. Oh, no, he always has four. And my weapon skill only drops to a four plus.
Who are you attacking, by the way?
The one that hasn't attacked yet. Okay. That is a wound, though. Minus three.
Storm shield. Fine.
And then the tail. Hits. Doesn't wound. Reroll ones. Doesn't wound.
So then I'll do the one that didn't attack.
Yep.
So he gets his two plus one for the Wolfenstone.
Yep.
Reroll on all hits and all wounds because of the one with stratagem.
Yep.
So it's, this will be on the fours.
Three won't hit, so yeah.
Be on fours, but then reroll all.
You can't because it's only failed hits.
Yeah. And then again, it's going to be
threes, three rerolling
all wounds. Doesn't matter.
Two. Four plus. Oh, one goes through. Oh, that actually might keep me in the game. I've then got three attacks with the Tervagon. All hit. Reroll the one to wound. That doesn't wound. Them two do. It's minus three, so you've got to take it on the Storm Shield first.
Fine.
And then the other one.
Fine.
Turn.
So I'll score two then.
Yep.
Point for Witch Hunter because the Zone Thrupp's died.
Yep.
and a point for making two charges.
Yep. Are you getting rid of counterattack?
I will be getting rid of counterattack.
Fair enough. That puts Drew on 18 to my 12. That's not really working much in my favour. And I've got three models left. Okay, here we go then. So, I've retreated onto objective 4. I'm then going to smite. I get out on a 7. For 2 wounds on him. I needed 3, really, because he's only got 3 wounds. So then, of course, I will... you know what? I'm going to cast Psychic Scream on the Wolfen. I don't get it. Shooting phase.
He can do a smite.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Yep. That's 1 on the Wolfen.
Yeah, it is. So that'll go on the claw.
Yep.
Where's the little dice? There we go. Ah.
So these are the devourers into the guy on 1 wound. His ballistic skill is suffering now, though. That's not good. That is, however, 3 wounds. Just fail 1 save, please, Drew.
Well, AP doesn't matter because it's failed Storm Shield.
No! Combat, 3 attacks with her. All hit. All wound, minus 3.
So they have to go on him first. What's the damage?
D6.
So you'll have to roll that because it's got to do his Feel No Pains.
5.
So, can I make 5 Feel No Pains?
Mid 3.
Yeah, but he's dead.
Yep.
So he'll get the attack.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's 2 more.
Yep.
Which go on Storm Shields. Field 1.
Yep.
Damage.
5.
5.
Oh, I might kill it.
Yes, you do. It's a kill Storm Shield as well.
That's really frustrating. I got so close to destroying a unit there.
So, but they'll get
the attack. Yes, yes. Do the hammer first.
3, because I wasn't charged this turn. They all miss.
Wow.
Because, obviously, I didn't charge, so they'll get the minus 1.
Yep.
And then claws. 2, 3, 4. Sergeant. 4. 3s. And these are going to be 5s and 6s. Nothing.
And then the hammer from the guy that's left?
Well, no, he'll not get the attack yet.
Why?
Because you get the... Oh, you went with them? Yeah, because it's the only combat.
Yeah.
I was only doing them because they died, yeah. So, yeah.
Two hits.
That'll be 2 wounds.
Yep, minus 3.
10.
Pass 1, fail 1, so that's 9 wounds she's taken. She's got 5 remaining. I score 1 point, secure objective 4, and I'm going to ditch area denial because I can't get it now. So let's have a look and see what cards Drew is going to draw in turn 5.
So the 3 I have to put down is secure 4,
which you can get by killing me hive time pretty easily.
Defend 4,
which you would get by the end of my turn easily.
And no prisoners.
Kill something. Well, you're going to kill both of them, probably.
So these two, obviously, will be moving there.
Yeah.
But the plasma pistol, because they've only got 2 wounds left.
Yeah. The plasma pistol and the weight of attacks that you're going to get from charging would take them out.
Yes. These guys would just go into that, just to try and go weight of attacks.
Yeah.
And...
I think we should call it there.
Yeah. So I've got 6 points ahead. Well, you scored a couple there, didn't you?
I scored 1.
So 5 points ahead, and I'm more than likely going to get another
3
and then 4 at the end of your turn if anything's still alive.
Yeah.
So.
Wow. Brutal, brutal game.
Yeah.
I think if I was to do something different, right, I'd have put my Carnifexes at the front instead of all the Gaunts. Let the Gaunts come back in as a second wave to then shoot all your Marines down. Because you chewed through them. I expected 1 unit to go, but being able to consolidate into the second one is what hurt us.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's what I would do slightly differently.
That was really quite fortunate.
I did actually like playing this High Fleet.
Really good.
Combat nids is very different to what I would normally play. I like shooting nids.
Yeah.
So to do that, forgetting Annihilation to shoot again.
Yeah, with your High Guard.
Yeah, I could have killed him then, yes. Which would have... You know, possible.
He hasn't done that much all game, but he's been a nuisance that you've been trying to get rid of.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah. And I would have had Area Denial last turn.
Yeah.
Which is when I actually had it in my hand.
Yeah.
So, Yeah, a fun game. I had a quite fun time playing with the Tyranids.
Yeah, I think it was good.
But you still got too many Marines left.
Yeah, I mean, these guys are all pretty much untouched. Yeah. There's not a lot there, but it's just bolters and stuff like that, so eventually you might chip a couple of wounds off things.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, listen, guys, that is it for today's battle report. Thank you very much for tuning in indeed. When the Space Wolves finally get their update, Drew will be back.
Yes.
Might not be straight away because you work away.
Yes.
But he will be back at some point with lots of new stuff. But we've also got Sean,
yes,
who's pretty much always available.
I think at some time we were planning on having a Space Wolf off as well.
We need to film a Space Wolf off.
Yeah.
We definitely need to do a Space Wolf off.
Because he goes a lot more heavy primaries than I do.
Yeah.
I rely more on the normal Marines and he likes a lot of the primaries. So
he does.
Two different armies as well.
So he does. Indeed. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Check out the rest of the channel and please subscribe and support us if you're able to do so. And thanks for watching. See you again soon.